We study a type of virus called a baculovirus that infects butterflies and moths in the caterpillar stage of their development. These viruses are embedded within structures called occlusion bodies, which are eaten by caterpillars. The virus then infects cells in the gut, where it replicates and then is released to infect cells in other tissues of the caterpillar. For a successful infection, the virus must overcome barriers, including a layer of extracellular matrix surrounding the gut, before it can spread to deeper tissues. We investigated how it does this. Cells in other contexts, including cancer cells, degrade extracellular matrix by assembling structures called invadosomes that contain a network of filaments made of the cytoskeletal protein actin. Assembly of actin filaments, along with the release of matrix-degrading enzymes, allows invadosomes to degrade and penetrate these extracellular matrix barriers. While observing insect cells infected with a baculovirus, we noticed infection caused clusters of actin-rich invadosomes to form, and these clusters change shape over time. We showed that a single viral protein that locates to the surface of the cell, called actin-rearrangement-inducing factor 1, or ARF1, is necessary and sufficient for actin filament assembly and invadosome formation. We also observed degradation of the extracellular matrix beneath the invadosomes. Our work suggests baculoviruses cause invadosome formation to allow virus-infected cells to pass through extracellular matrix barriers. This may allow released viruses to spread through barriers that separate different tissues of the caterpillar, and similar events may occur during viral infections of other animals, including humans. Eventually, the viruses spread through the body, causing the caterpillar to die and liquefy, releasing viruses within occlusion bodies that are eaten by other caterpillars.